Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the walkthrough. I went a little OCD in this room, and I've gone a little bonkers. But I found the solution. Seriously, that's all you have to do. Why didn't I think about using a spin attack before? I have no idea, but there's a switch underneath that crate. And yeah, there you go. There is the treasure chest. This better contain something dang good. Welcome back to the continuation. Let's get to the boss right away. I was a little laggy there for whatever reason. Ooh boy. And we are here. Ground shaking. Platform sinking into lava. That's never good signs. Oh boy! Yes, Volvagia is the boss. Let's get this started. Basically, it's a game of whack-a-dragon. Yeah, whack-a-dragon, not whack-a-mole. All you need is your megaton hammer and you're pretty much good to go. Stand at one side here and just wait for him to pop up. I said wait for him to pop up and then, yeah, I was a little too close there. That was my mistake there. And then you just have to hit him with the hammer to make him vulnerable and then hit him with your sword. And that's pretty much it there, and he eventually comes out of the top, comes out and flies above you, shoots some fire at you, sometimes he'll drop boulders on top of you as well. It's pretty easy to just, like, circle around him like that, and yeah, you're not gonna take any- Wah! I must have accidentally touched him. I never actually had trouble getting under- walking underneath him before like that. Ah well, maybe I'll just go around the perimeter the next time. It's not really a hard boss, I'm just kinda being derp-a-derp here, and yeah. But you should know me, that, you know, to do that as usual. So, there we go. I guess you can only hit him one time per pass. If you want to be really cheap when he flies out like that, you can hang off the edge and he can't touch you whatsoever with fire or boulders. And here comes the boulders. All you have to do is look out for the shadows that are on the platform. Well, not, it's just one big platform, not platforms. There is no plural here. And as you see, he just goes right back in there. The boulders pretty much follow him around, so it's actually pretty predictable, as you can see there. And now he's gonna pop out there, I suppose. Oh, now he's switching around places, excuse me. And yep. There we go. Yeah, you can only do one hit. Too bad. So sad. And he's gonna pop out there. Yeah, he is. And he's gonna fly around. Let's just show you the little edge grab trick for the fun of it, I guess. Come on. There we go. It's kind of hard to do. Otherwise, you'll like jump off the edge accidentally. Well, I'm not gonna be able to demonstrate it now. Dang it, it was too late. But still, whenever you grab onto the ledge gently like that, when he's flying out above you, you don't have to worry about him whatsoever. And this should be getting close to the end of him, I think. You know what? Edge grab, edge grabby. There we go. Now do your thing. Yep, I'll just be hanging out here. Don't mind me. You can keep dropping rocks all over the place. What? You're kidding me, right? I could have swore that you were. Wow. I'm serious. I never ever got hit by a rock hanging off the ledge there before. So I always considered it to be a cheap tactic, basically, which is why I haven't really used it for this boss battle yet. And wow, it's like. You start recording, and anything that can go bad, goes bad. But I'm not really taking all that much damage anyway in this battle. It's not that... I should really keep my mouth shut, shouldn't I? Hammer. Pop out of a hole, please. I've got a fairy, so this isn't, like, a big deal whatsoever. Boink! And... ah, there we go. It's about time. See, if I would have died there, I would have just got revived by the fairy anyway. It's just like, eh, oh well. I can't believe I took a hit hanging off the edge of that. I have stood on the edge of the platform before, and I haven't taken a hit. I don't get it. I don't get it, man. Anyway, the head disappears last and gives you a heart piece for your troubles. Yahoo! I can finally leave this place forever! Took 6 parts to get through this thing, so I am a teeny tiny bit burnt out. And now watch the ring above Death Mountain. Oh boy! And thus it clears out, well, the fire clears out, and becomes the normal, gentle smoke ring once again. Oh, we get another chocolate coin! By the way, this reminds me, a bunch of people have said, I've never seen the chocolate coins in colors, I've only seen them in silver and gold. Well, that is typically what they come in. But I have seen chocolate coins in different colors before, and I've had them too, so... That's why they remind me of chocolate coins, because it just has those colors, so to speak. Is that so? Please don't hug me. I will, and I will cherish it greatly. And then unwrap it later and eat it. Yay! She is done. And now we'll get transported out of this place. I won't, just... please don't hug me. Preferably don't touch me. Thank you. And now we are outside Death Mountain Crater. Well, we're in Death Mountain Crater, excuse me. There's a couple of things that I would like to do in here, so I'm just going to cut to them as I get to them. You may recall that wall over there that you can climb on. See that over off to the side there? Well, what I'm going to do is actually climb down it. Well, there's a little shortcut here that I made earlier by breaking one of those boulders blocking the bridge with the Megaton Hammer, and that was kind of like a tongue twister, if you will. And now I'm going to carefully... there we go. Now go over to this opening right here. What's that? What's that I see? There we go. There's a heart piece. Now I'm gonna come back here as a kid. Be right back. As long as I'm in the area... oh yeah! Gotta pick this sucker up as long as I'm near Ganon's castle. And now let's get back to childhood. Now you may ask yourself, how do you get back to Death Mountain Crater? This is how. Well, I should say, how do you get back to the spot with that bean patch I mentioned a little bit earlier? Well, that's what I'm going back to do right now. And this is why I went back to childhood. And, oh no, it's so hot, what are we gonna do? I mean, we can't stay in here for too long, and for some reason, you can't wear the tunic that protects you from the heat. But in the meantime, what I'm going to be doing is just staying here for the time that I can stay in here, which is in 1 minute and 44 seconds, and get myself a skull tulip and plant the bean over at this soft soil patch. As you see, it's right by the warp point. I thought it was closer to the temple, but, well, it's here. It's a lot a lot easier to get to than I remember, and there we go. And now, plant yourself a bean right here. And now go back to adulthood. Actually, as long as we're here as a kid, I can do this now that I have the lens of truth quite easily. See this place right here? Go inside. I don't believe I showed this place before. This is the treasure box shop. Open the chest, and surprise! If you find a key inside, you'll be able to advance. Left or right, try your luck. Sure, let's play money-making game. So he gives you a key to start this game off at a small fee, and now we're in here. Normally, this is a guessing game. You would have to choose between two treasure chests. But we can cheat just a little teensy bit. I wonder which one I'm gonna choose! And that's basically how you can win this game each and every time. And... Oops, I accidentally turned on the lens of truth once again! Yeah, as you can see, this is going to be ridiculously easy with the lens of truth to win this thing. And there we go. If you'd like, I suppose you could keep coming back here for rupees to grind for as long as you want to. I suppose, maybe. And there is another key. Wah! I believe you have to do this 5 times. So the chances of you doing this without the lens of truth are pretty slim. So I definitely recommend that you do this mini game with lens of truth to save yourself a little hassle. And look at this, you get to the treasure room! Oh! Yeah, that was pathetically easy. With the lens of truth. And there we go. Oh, I clicked through the winner thing. Dang it! Oh well. I wonder what happens if you win this game again, actually. I'm not sure about that. Look who won the game 2 times in a row! Now let's see what's behind this door. I should say, let's see what the prize is after you get the piece of heart. Purple rupee, huh? Oh, I suppose that's a pretty nice prize since you pay 10 to get in here. That's a pretty quick way to grind rupees. Okay, let's go do some more stuff. You may remember this log over here at Zora's River. Well, if you go over here on top of it carefully... Some frogs are looking at you from underwater. That may be a little bit creepy. Oh boy, but they're incredibly cute. First, play the Song of Storms. Yes, they sing with you. And they'll be like, yay, we're so happy! Wow, that melody is so cool. Ribbit! Sing in the rain, oh, what a feeling. Ribbit! Please take this as a token of our frogish gratitude. Ribbit! Alright, see you. Ribbit! Man, these frogs are more useful than Froggy. Like 100 times just from this heart piece. Now what you want to do is, you see your song list over here? Play all these top 6, including the Song of Storms, which is what I just played here, and a little mini game will start for you. And for whatever reason, one of the frogs grows. I don't understand why, but the other 5 songs make the other 5 frogs grow. Maybe the power of music enlightens them so much that it causes a growth spurt or something like that. But wow, that is quite a nice prize. What else do you give me, man? I was gonna cut forward, actually, but it might be worth showing all the prizes these guys give you. You get another... Holy cow! Epona song? What do you give me? Are you guys all gonna give me, like, 50 rupees apiece? That would be really nice, I have to say. Yay! Young lad... Yep, and my wallet's full, but I'm not stopping there. Whoop. Wait. There we go. Yeah, I think they're all going to give you 50 rupees, and they all say the same thing, basically. But they are definitely more useful than Froggy in every possible way. Oh, and definitely more useful than Big. That is... Oh, yeah. Anyway, the last song... What is the last... I forgot which one I haven't covered yet. Oh, yeah, Saria's song. It was... Do 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 do. The frogs are so silly. Yo! And now something different will happen. You play the I think something different will happen. We all should practice it. Ribbit, take rupees and just is this the same thing? But I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be a mini game that comes out of this, not from the rupees. Let's try this one more time. Will you have anything to say? Look at us! We're all huge frogs! We're the world-famous, fabulous five froggish tenors! Wow! Make us jump so we can eat the bugs flying above us, Ribbit. Oh, this game. Basically, you have to play the note where there is a bug above one of the frog's heads, basically. And that was wrong. Apparently, the combination of this is always the same. I really, really don't feel like going through this trial and error, I should say, trying to memorize all these frogs. So hold on just a second, please. Call me wimpy, but I got the solution here, because I just didn't feel like wasting time. apparently... I'll just do this in order here. I should say I will show you as I go here. It is... Yeah. It's A, left, right. Apparently you have to do this fast enough. Maybe I'll just put the combination on screen as I look at the thingy here. There we go! Young boy, you did great! Yeah, you have to do this pretty quick, and that's not something that I'm good at since I'm just getting used to these button controls, plus the fact that, oh, never mind, you actually don't have to use up, but I was using the A button and the C stick because I had to switch between things quickly. But anyway, yeah, there is a piece of heart for your troubles. Now I'm gonna go back to adulthood. And we're back at Death Mountain Crater. So what am I going to be doing here? There's a magic bean that somehow managed to grow through all of this incredibly hot heat. And I should probably jump off here. Yeah! That's how you get this piece of heart up here. And wow, this smoke is black. How do I get down from up here? Anyway, can I just, like, jump down from... Yeah, I can. There we go. Oh, the bean just saved me. Anyway, I think that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part when I figure out what the heck I'm going to be doing next, because there's some stuff that I could do, or I could go right over to the ice cave. I don't know, but I'll see you when I see you.